understanding now. Keeping journals is for those who cannot or dare not speak out. So I shall set up a journal, being only a rather lonely young girl in a very small and hidden memory. On my return to Louisiana in November, after an absence of many months, I heard the red salamander disunion and war muttered in threatened terms. Surely no native-born woman loves her country better than I love America. It is the Union that I love, not any divided special section of it. Unidentified Louisiana Unionist Painter, December 1st, 1860.
I am for my country. Should Tennessee go out of the Union, I shall continue to denounce secessionism and war against the storms of fanaticism at the North and the assaults of the demagogues and traitors at the South. Once destroyed, this Union can never be reconstructed. William G. Brown, Tennessee Avenue, January 15th,
1860. Got a Union pistol in their display.
Captured.
That guy was pretty tall.
This Southern Confederacy must be supported now by calm determination and cool brains. We have faced hard and we must play our best, but a stir is not to
I don't believe I could fit in any of the coats.
No, I don't. I know I could.
Look how narrow some of these are.
Yeah.
Number six.
Really?
No, number 10. I believe that'd be the same. No. Yeah, okay.
Are the wagons exactly the same?
Yeah.
Are the exact same horses? Five horses, two different pictures, two different days.
No, they're not. They're more at mine.
Thank you. Bobby Lee.
And I earnestly pray that a merciful God will extend to you his blessing and protection. With an unceasing admiration of your constancy and devotion to your country, and a grateful remembrance of your kind and generous consideration for myself, I bid you all an affectionate farewell. R. E. Lee, General.
Know him? You ever hear of him? Colonel Taylor, Adjutant General.
After 4 years of arduous service, Mark found surpassed courage and fortitude. The Army of Northern Virginia has been compelled to yield to overwhelming numbers and resources. I need not tell the brave survivors of so many hard-fought battles who have remained steadfast for the life. But I have considered to this result no distrust of them, but feeling that valor and devotion could accomplish nothing that could compensate for the loss that must have attended the contingents of the contest. I determined to avoid the useless sacrifice of those whose past services have endeared them to it. By terms of the agreement, officers and men can return to their homes and remain until exchange. We will take with you the satisfaction that proceeds from the consciousness of duty faithfully performed. And I earnestly pray that a merciful God will extend to you his blessing and protection. With an unceasing admiration of your constancy and your courage, your country, and a great concern also for kind and generous consideration for our citizens.
Henceforth, we must live subservient to anti domination. We have no country to repress, no flag to point to. The hated stars and stripes are floating insolently over us. Such are my thoughts. What is life to us? Country gone, property gone. Our people are crushed under the iron heel of the conqueror. Our very will is exalted over our heads.
I gave him a bunch of swords and stuff, huh? Cool.
Well, yeah, you got these battle swords, but that's a honking sucker there.
Yeah.
He must have been Scottish.
He wanted to reach out and touch someone from far away.